You can't tell me, can you, fella? Oh yeah, I know why. It's because you're Viet Cong. I'm right, aren't I? You are nothing but a filthy communist! You, son, are gonna tell me where the gorilla's hideout is. By the time I'm done beating information out of you, you are gonna be begging for death to come take you away.
Nice.
You gotta get his ugly mug, of course. Oh!
Right.
Oh!
So, all right, Cliff, the vet that's kind of lost his mind, he has one of the fastest weapons in the game, the machete. It is a very, very fast weapon, and the one thing he will do throughout this entire fight, he will go down the different chutes and try to escape, and wow.
And gently float down the side of...
supposed to happen. That's a good photo op moment right there. You get some really good points. It's a really easy one to find. Careful of the flares.
Oh, come on, Frank. You've never smelled flares before, Frank. Come on.
So what Cliff will do is he will use the flares to make you go towards them. And once you get to that, he will jump down and attack you. So it's luring you to where he is, and then he just jumps down and attacks you. But if you jump onto the aisles here, he doesn't like that very much.
Hey!
He
can't go down there, though.
Yeah, he has one other attack, but I don't think he'll be showing it here. I'll be showing it off later. Let's see. Oh, there he is.
Oh, shit! No!
Got him.
Oh!
Nice.
You. Over there. Here. Take this. My granddaughter. She was done in by those damn zombies. When I heard her scream, I just lost it. Everything went white suddenly. The war, it wasn't over. Not for me. It never ended.
Machete! I want that! Machete. I want that machete! Yes! Look at that!
Wow, that's fast.
I know! It is such a good weapon! Wow. Alright, one other weapon I want to show off because it's the only place you can get it. Oh, no reading! No time for light reading! We got this! Buzz! Oh god, I love this weapon. Let me get another one. God, I love this one.
Wheel of Fortune!
Alright. After you defeat Cliff, he gives you a key. And when I started this game the very first time, I had no idea this was over here. It's right next door. There we go. Three survivors!
Help!
They think we're the madman. Do you know there's a combination of the machete, and you can also get a hockey mask? So you can run around as Jason Voorhees. It's awesome.
I'm here to help you.
That right there, your reward for beating Cliff, not only for you do you get the machete, you also get a magazine that raises all food items by 100% healing factor.
You also get 3 survivors, I'm getty.
Yay, and guess what? They're all pansies, which means they're going to run and stop.
Okay, so are you going into the park?
Yes.
Why are you going into the park? That's like
why.
The one place you shouldn't take them.
Right there is why. I'm running out of time. Oh, yeah. They got stuck on the door.
Let me get the door for you, madam. Stay there.
There we go. Come on, Barbara. Well, I'm sitting here getting munched. You're running into a door with no collision detection.
Oh, you wanted to save these fools?
Sometimes I don't know. Oh, that right there. That makes me the maddest about this game. These are the types of survivors that run into a horde of zombies and stop to cry. The big difference with these guys, though, do you remember the Bert thing? The Bert saga of trying to get one guy to not die to take him to the security room? These guys have his personality, but they will respond to your call quicker.
Well, if they lasted this long, you know, you figured they'd know how the game works by now.
I don't know what it is about the beginning survivors.
If we follow this guy, maybe we'll end up living.
The beginning survivors are the dumbest things you will ever see when it comes to AI programming. But these guys are actually okay. Like, they'll stop in the face of danger, but if you call them, they will immediately come running. I just don't get it.
Well, that's not too bad, I guess. It makes them easier to save, I guess.
Yes, but guess what? Somebody got caught.
Oh, no.
If you're wondering where the convicts are, I think they're running into a wall on the other side of the park, so we're good.
Shit, get him! I can't! There's trees everywhere!
How the hell did this happen?
Josh!
Josh, why?
I had a Slim Jim in my pocket.
Snap into a Slim Jim.
What's it made out of? Brains.
It's made out of Macho Man. It's a zombie Slim Jim.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, finally. We're going to get these guys out of here. Another thing that happens on day 2, twice as many zombies show up. So now, not only do we have to deal with the raincoat guys, we also have to deal with twice as many zombies.
I don't know how you're gonna do this, man.
Every day, the amount of zombies doubles. So if it's not bad enough that you get more zombies, just wait until 6 o'clock when they double their power again. Or 7 o'clock, excuse me. Whatever time that was. Nighttime.
You really want to do this?
Yes! Oh, I am going to go through it and damn it all if I don't tear my hair off first.
You are a fucking madman, dude.
I have a lot of patience.
I'm just putting that out there. Way more than me, that's for sure.
I have patience of the gods. Oh, okay. At least they all followed me. That's what I'm happiest about.
Oh, God, you're running out of time.
All told, this was probably one of the best runs I've ever had when recording Dead Rising since episode 1, where I literally just had to watch cutscenes.
That was a pretty smooth transport, though. Relatively speaking.
Like I said, these survivors, while they are stupid, they at least listen to directions.
Maybe they up the AI when the days get long, when there's more days to make up for the more zombies, I guess?
No, they don't. Oh, just wait till day 3. They don't.
Oh, boy.
I think they get
That's the challenge. Here, try and take this idiot all the way over to across these 3 buildings with 80 billion zombies in the way. Good luck.
God, that would... Oh, I can't wait. Day 3 also has some of my favorite psychopaths. So I can't wait. Simultaneously, because I know it's going to be entertaining for the viewer to watch me absolutely lose my shit, but again, it'll be entertaining for me because it has some of the best psychopaths. They save the best for last.
Just imagining you sitting there playing this right now, just going, "God, I can't fucking play this."
Actually, this was the calmest I've ever played because everything went right.
Well, yeah, in this playthrough, so yeah, that worked. This worked out pretty well.
Excellent. Hey, look, we got another level.
And you even leveled up. Wow.
90,000 points.
90,000.
And what did we get? More attack power. Yes.
So more attack power, pretty much unstoppable chainsaw. We're sitting pretty right now, I'd say.
We have a new lead.
Don't ride the motorcycle in the mall. That's just rude. Why are there no zombies around?
Because plot convenience.
I don't...
We have a new lead. There, look. We've got 9 hours to finish this. We've got plenty of time to goof off.
Well, what are we going to do?
We're going to show off a couple of the moves that we've gotten.
Yay.
There should be one more scoop showing up as soon as we leave here. And it's one of the ones that makes people the most uncomfortable. As soon as you see the name, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about.
Why does Otis always tell you about scoops the second you leave the room?
I don't know. Aha.
Oh, yeah. I remember this one.
We'll be doing that one next time, actually, because we have so much time to go find Isabella that we are just going to do a bunch of fun stuff next time. We're going to be doing a lot of item searching. Going to be goofing off.
So now we got 5 minutes of just hacking people down. Enjoy.
Let's look at some of the moves that we have acquired, and they are actually useful on not only zombies, but these raincoat guys. You can actually kill cultists with the special moves that you get for leveling up. Let's go ahead and get this out of the way. This won't be the most spectacular look at some of the moves we have, but let's go ahead and try the double lariat. Let's see, that's holding down the stick and pressing X. Oh,
it's too bad that it throws whatever weapon you have, though.
Right, which is why holding down the stick and pressing A, you do a football tackle, and no, they caught me. No! They stripped me naked!
But they didn't shave your chest.
Thank God, I don't want them to shave anything while I'm out unconscious.
He's got the chest hair of the Chosen One!
The last thing the cultists will do, out of all their attacks, this one is the worst. At any time, they can blow fairy dust in your face, knock you unconscious, take everything you have, and if you have survivors with you, they will still be out on the field losing health. Perfect.
They just leave them there?
Yeah, they just leave them there. Everything you have is gone. And wherever your survivors were, they're still there. So, in order to kill these guys, I have a bag of frozen peas and a stepladder. Let's do this.
Charge!
Charge! But there is a ceremonial sword up here. Thank God.
Joe, I told you to grab the sword. Otherwise, see, look what happened. That's just awful.
I just love the scenario. There's like a panicking naked man running around with a stepladder and a sword, just going, I'll kill you all.
Make sure he doesn't grab the sword. Oh, he got the sword.
God damn it. Jerry, that was your job.
I'm sorry, you know, the one time, you know?
Who the fuck it happened? Uh-oh, it broke. Time to bludgeon these guys to death with a stepladder.
Did you get the sword fixed? I thought I did.
Look how far they fly. This is our new attack power being shown off.
Wow.
Uh-oh.
Peas.
There we go.
It's just how surreal this game can be sometimes.
It's dumb. It's so dumb. After you kill the last guy, you get the passcode to leave. And we are going to end up back in Leisure Park. Where?
Oh, no.
Right here. We actually passed by it while we were escorting those last three survivors.
Well, okay.
Yep.
Cool.
Barely any time has passed, and we didn't have any survivors, so this is actually okay. I'll just reload a save, and we'll be fine. But now, let's take a look at the cliff boss fight. There's a couple things we missed. First of all, we got an achievement!
That ass! Oh, right. Achievement.
Be sure to photograph those psychopaths. You get achievement points for it.
Oh!
That's what happens when you fall for his trap. He will actually come up and stab you in the back.
That's a Sephiroth kill right there.
Yep, he also has grenades if you can't find him. So if he throws down a flare and the flare goes out and you still can't find him, if you're in the general vicinity, he'll start throwing grenades. And this is really dumb.
I'm going to find him and what I do.
Let's show off some of the moves a lot better. You mentioned that whatever you're holding, you will actually lose in the double lariat. But did you know that whatever you're holding actually doubles as a separate attack when using the double lariat?
For a while, until you lose it.
Well, then you just go and pick it up again. It's not like it's gone forever.
It'd be really cool if you had, like, a tether attached to it, so you'd be like Kratos.
That would be amazing! Let's see, did we miss anything? We already did the football tackle. Click L and press A. The judo throw, we'll deal with later, and the double lariat. So we are all caught up with all the skills that we have at this point in time. And I know I'm one level back from where we should be. This is in a run that did not go as well as I'd hoped.
Yeah. Because everything's been peachy keen so far.
Right. But until the next one where we just goof off a lot.